arguing that laws banning same-sex marriage are unconstitutional. You'll hear Justice Antonin Scalia questioning her.
The thing about marriage is that it's controlled and regulated by the states. And of course, we all know there are exclusions in cases like Loving and Sablocki and Turner, where in each case with prisoners, with people behind them in child support payments, with a mixed-race couple, and even though some of those exclusions were quite traditional, they could not stand.
Not all societies banned mixed-race marriages. In fact, not even all states. Do you know of any society prior to the Netherlands that permitted same-sex marriage?
As a legal matter, no?
As a legal matter.
I am not.
Not a single society until the Netherlands in 2001. Are you telling me they were all? I don't know what.
No, what I'm saying is, taking that tradition as it is, the court still needs a reason to maintain that tradition when it has the effect.
The issue, of course, is not whether there should be same-sex marriage, but who should decide the point?
Justice Antonin Scalia there talking with attorney Mary Bonato at the Supreme Court today as justices heard oral arguments about same-sex marriage. A decision in the case is expected in June. You're listening to Here and Now.
More Here and Now in just a moment on WAMU 88.5. Good afternoon. I'm Tamika Smith, filling in for Matt Brogan. Coming up in the next hour is All Things Considered, and here with the preview is Ellen Francis. Good afternoon, Ellen.
Good afternoon, Tamika. Well, as many hope for calm in Baltimore today, some local branches of the NAACP in Virginia are speaking out against the police treatment of African Americans by police and offering a solution of sorts. WAMU 88.5's Emory Morgan will explain. Meanwhile, after a night of violent riots in Baltimore, some residents today were focused on rebuilding and getting a handle on things as many protesters returned to those streets this afternoon. NPR's Joanna Summers will have the latest. And in a relatively surprising move today, the NFL gave up its ex-exempt status today. Some of the impact of that decision and share the rest of today's news when All Things Considered begins at 4.
Thank you, Elliot. And coming up later today on Marketplace, a look into advanced placement courses. Why some students sign up and others don't. And why that could be now 5:01. That's Marketplace today at 6 on WAMU 88.5. Support for WAMU 88.5 comes from Pepco's Energy Savings Program, providing technical and financial assistance to Maryland business customers for upgrades to energy efficient lighting and more. Information at pepco.com/business.